All right, back at it. Looks like we're gonna replace, I think I have a 12-foot 2x6, so we'll replace 12 feet of this for now. And this is probably the worst section of the outer framing, because, well, there is no framing there, and that's as good as not being there as well. So we'll get to work putting a fresh piece in there. Wish me luck. Yeah, I'm right there banging out some places where they tried to reinforce it and repair it. Some janky 2x4s and 2x6s. So that was fun. I think that's about a 14-foot piece right there. And right there, I do a lot of that. I call it mental building, where I just sit there and contemplate what I should be doing next and what it's going to look like. And the older I get, the more I do that. So, fun stuff. All right, we got the baseboard in there. That was fun. Wasn't too bad. Obviously, a lot of these lower ends of the 2x4s are rotten, so I will have to replace a few of those on this section. Most of them. I didn't put this 1x4 here at the base of the wall yet, because this is obviously sunk down and I'll have to jack it up. I might fabricate something, you know, just have some 2x4s setting up in the door jamb there and coming down, and then having a floor jack push them up so I can get those pieces in there, because I also got to put, you know, the 1x4 in, and then, you know, the spacer for the subfloor that will eventually go in there. So I'll put the 1x4s out to here, and then have this gap here, and then, you know, 1x4s on down. So got one more 8-foot section to put in here. Hopefully I have another 1x6 in the shed that's long enough for that section, because I don't feel like spending another $10 for an 8-foot 2x6 these days. So hopefully I got one that'll fit there. So as you can see in the background there, I just put a cinder block and a car jack and one 2x4 up into the doorwell there, or the doorway, and yeah, I was able to just jack that up so I can get some space to put these 1x4s in there. What better than what I was doing before, by just trying to use a pry bar to lift up as I try to squeeze it in there. So just another little trick I learned along the way. Just drilling the holes there so I could put the leg bolt, that carriage bolts through, and get it all secured. All right, we got this left side of the door all completed, you know, as far as what we're doing for now, and button back up. And I just had this stuff extra coming out, because at some point it's going to be cut off where the door jamb is, and I think I'm going to be getting a slightly wider door anyway, so it'll probably be cut farther back on each side. So we got this one done. It's sagging here a little bit because that bolt isn't tightened down, because obviously I have to put the runner across and replace this first. So anyway, that's where we are for now. The piece I found to put in here, it's all right. It's in, you know, structurally good shape, but there's a few holes from nails in it, and it's just kind of stained. So I put it in there, but I wish I could have or would have gotten a newer one. A brand new one, even though they're overpriced, but it just would have looked better. Oh well, it is what it is. It's in there. All right, we got this whole section in. the baseboard from the bottom of the wall put in. I had to use one used 2x6, but it was in still fine shape, not rotten or anything. That's just rough, not rot. So we're good there. Button it back up with the aluminum siding for now and go around. I'll probably go to the back side before I do the front end here. Back side, it's in the other side where the back door is, not the back facing of the trailer.